Alright guys, we're going to go over the setup of the boat before deployment, right? What we want in it, the components, and we're going to kind of walk it from the front to the back of the boat to make sure it's set up the same way every single time when it goes out and we have no questions. We're going to start at the front of the boat. You guys can see down here, there's one green webbing. It goes through one D-ring on one side and one D-ring on the other side. And it has this carabiner that just clipped right here. That's our tow strap. If we need to get towed or if we need to pull the boat, that's what we're pulling from. These D-rings are the rated rings for this boat to get pulled. So I'm making sure that my tow strap is there and it's ready and good to go. As we come through, we've already went with tying down the tank. And underneath my tank, there's my Peterson tube. So everything is strapped in nicely and tight. So that's all in place. The next piece we have here is we have this dry bag. In this dry bag, we have a foot pump. There's an emergency patch kit, some glow sticks, a couple of flashlights, and then the batteries for that flashlights. And then anything else you guys think you'd need, we can throw in that dry bag so it stays dry. Underneath that dry bag, there's this red NRS bag. In that bag, we have a Pelican case, and then we'll show a separate video with the stuff from the bag. There's two straps for doing some par buckling. There's a tow strap that has some floats on it for the back of the boat that we'll talk about also. And then two throw bags. We don't want to go out without throw bags. And then those are connected to the boat, to the D-rings with some carabiners also. As we're coming down the side of the boat, the right side of the boat or the starboard side of the boat, that's going to be where we're always going to have our flip lines. That way if this boat flips over, we always know where the lines are at and we're not having to search. So right side of the boat, one D-ring, back D-ring, two flip lines, ready to go. As we're coming around, before we start moving with the boat on the ground or taking it down to the dock, we want to make sure that our motor's up and in the lock position tilted. There's a lock on this side, so that's ready to go and set. We have our fuel line connected, and then we've taken our fuel line and we basically tucked it up alongside the boat here just to keep it out of the way, all the way up. Our priming bulb is back here in the back where the operator will be, and it runs all the way up to the fuel tank. We always carry four paddles. So we've got two paddles on one side and two paddles strapped on the other side. That's just the stuff. This is the minimum we want to go out with before we go get deployed and go out into the bay or to rivers or the lake. Some other options might be you want to take GPS units, radios, and any other equipment you see deemed necessary. We like to keep most of the center of the boat clean. There's going to be an operator, a coxswain, and a bowman in here, and then any people that we're rescuing. So this gives us kind of full use space or floor space in the boat.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip that started from this tropic point aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailing man, skipper brave and sure. Five passengers set sail that day for a three-hour tour. The weather started getting rough, the tiny ship was tossed. If not for the courage of a fearless crew, the middle would be lost. The middle would be lost. The ship set ground on the shore of this uncharted desert isle, with Gilligan, the skipper too, a millionaire.